Count down with us.
Much better.
This is Joe Urbanski, our CEO. Say, what's up, Joe?
So we are under some fun and interesting circumstances. We, the two of us, are both going to be facilitating and moderating this session. So see, you'll see us pop up and down from the stage to the platform down here where we've set up our really, really fancy technology and software to talk to all of you in the chat under my personal Joe Urbanski account. But we are excited to get this session started. If you're ready, say, oh yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Turn to the person on your left or on your right and say, hey, I'm glad you're here. If you're in the chat, say, let's do this. All right, it's all set, and you can now hear us on streaming. So hello and welcome. My name's Joe Urbanski, and this is Jack. No, we won't do the whole introduction once again. What I do want to ask you to do is start thinking about the answer to this question. Most strategy and planning meetings blank. So if you're with us in the chat, drop the answer in the chat, and if you're with us here, obviously in person, you're gonna talk to each other. Fill in the blank, take 10 seconds, and just tell somebody one thing, one word, one thought, one phrase. Most strategy and planning meetings blank. Take a moment, do that now.
They're working on it.
She gave me the thumbs up.
Oh, she did?
She did.
Oh, okay, good.
Okay. All right, if you can hear me, say, oh yeah. Some of you just learned the negative side of sitting all by yourself. You don't have a partner to talk. You're like, oh my goodness, we're gonna talk to each other today. Yes, we are, we sure are. Two quick responses. Most strategy and planning meetings, what? Who's got? Suck. Wow, we're going to start. Suck. Who agrees or said some synonym with suck? That's half of the room here. Okay. Do we have anything else?
So
I got one and then two.
Important.
They're important. They're important and they suck. Is that possible? Yes, it is. Right? And what else?
Stressful.
They're stressful. They're important, they're stressful, and still You said it, not me. They suck. Yeah, absolutely. They're no good. So we have to find a way to do things better, to do things differently, to do things more intentionally. If you're with us on that, give us an oh yeah. All right, love that. So all development, everything that we're doing within our strategy is tied to what? Everyone shout out the word.
Culture.
And if you're here because of that word, you came into this room because of the word culture, say uh-huh. Right? How many of you know culture is really super duper important? Right? In your organizations, in your family, in any relationship that you have, it's all super duper important. So today, just for the time being, for about an hour, look at Jack and I as your chief culture officers. We're going to be your CCOs today. All right? Is that okay for 1 hour? All right, cool. And so if you're like, well, who are these people who just said they're now our chief culture officers? Coming from the Total Solutions Group, a little bit of our manifesto, kind of why we do the work that we do, and we want you to kind of buy in with us to this purpose, this mission, this vision, this idea that we spend more time at work than we do at home, yes or yes, right? 8 hours, sometimes 10, sometimes 12, when you're away at a conference for 3 or 4 days. Think of the last time you went away with your family for 3 or 4 days. We'll commit to the conference. We won't miss our work meetings, but we might skip out on family things. So first, that's not good, and that's a whole nother session. but because we spend so much time at work, work needs to be a place where we become the best version of ourselves in the work that we do and the organization that we're a part of, so that not only do we get better, but the organization gets better because of the work that we do. If you're with me on that, give me another uh-huh. Right? That's kind of the burning reason why we do the work that we do at the Total Solutions Group. We work with strategic consultants. We do focus on results-based training, dynamic keynotes, workshops, things of that nature. You're going to get a little bit of all of that while you are here today. So right now, we're your partner in aligning your culture, your strategy, and your capability so that you can move all of this together. And we're going to do 5 things today. We're gonna breeze through a lot of these. We're gonna plant a lot of seeds so that you can really start working on this. The first one is establish your 4 cornerstones. Go ahead and say 4 cornerstones. I'm like, wow, this is like class. It is. And you know what? You'll remember it better because you're participating fully. All right, second is defining your strategic pillars. You're like, wait, these are the learning outcomes. Yes, they are. We're gonna make sure to hit all of these. Then define a fly vision, a vision that is fascinating, it's lucid, and it's yearned for. Tied directly to your culture. Then develop the strategic discipline to take that and move it forward. And then lastly is execute with precision. This is what we call purposeful execution. All right, so this is the focus of the day. And if you hate lectures, you're gonna love this. If you came in going, oh, I hope this is gonna be a lecture and I hope he's just gonna talk at us the whole time, you are in the wrong place. We're gonna do 3 things. We're gonna have some what? Everyone say fun.
Fun.
We're gonna learn some stuff. Go ahead, say stuff. And lastly, we're gonna feel how? Empowered, so that you can actually do something with it, but not tomorrow, next week. We're gonna take action when? Today, right here, right now, because we know after this session, you're going to see Michael Phelps, and you're not gonna be thinking about this session again. So we gotta start working on this today, right here, and right now. And if you're willing, if you're committed, if you're ready to go, say, oh yeah.
Oh, yeah.
If you're willing to prove it, say, oh yeah. Good, prove it. Put your stuff down. Please stand up. If you're at home, go ahead, stand up too. That's right, stand up if you are able. Home, in person, wherever you are, as you stand, put your hands up all the way up. Get a good stretch in there. Stretch to your left, your other left. That's right, we see you. Stretch to your other side. Get a good stretch in there. It is too early in the morning not to. All right, stretch all the way down. Touch your toes. Don't hit your head on the chair. Come on back up, point to yourself, say, I now commit 100%. Say, I will apply what I learned.
I will apply what I learned.
Look at your neighbor and say, hey, you. Say, you're gonna have a good time. Look at somebody else and say, so are you. Now, because we're in the COVID pandemic world, you have options. You are welcome to give high tens to other people that are welcome to give high tens. If you're giving fist bumps, give fist bumps, elbows, or just wave. But I want you to interact with 3 people. Do that now. Say hello to your friends all the way in your house or your work or wherever you are virtually. once again, if you're ready to get this going, say, oh yeah. Love it. We want to bring the energy to our culture, do we not? How many of you feel a little bit more energized now than you did just a moment ago? All right? Imagine if every day your CEO said, all right, if you're ready, everyone stand up, let's do this. Right? We got to raise our game. We got to raise our game when we're having this really important conversation about culture. Because as they take a really deep breath to do this, ready? Culture is the vision, mission, and the values. It is also your standards and the branding. It is also the leadership and the management and the infrastructure, how we pull it all together. It's the people, the performance, and the processes. Also the rituals, common language, and of course the everyday goals and moving to your strategy. And guess what? That's just your internal culture. So I gotta take a whole nother breath for the external culture. Ready for this? Your external culture, this is about the products, the services, the community, the industry, the client impact, the marketing, the sales, the performance. It is everything, right? And then beyond that, you also have your subcultures of your country or the countries where your people are working, the locations or the regions where people are coming from, the marketplace that you are serving. We're not going to do this in one breath. The customers, the executive team, and organizational leaders, employees, and their beliefs, and life outside work. So culture is a lot, yes? Would you agree, yes or yes? Right, and we knew that, and you knew that coming into this session. That's why we're not talking about it over and over. You know that, but the point is, we only have today. We only have this 1 hour with you. So we want to plant a lot of seeds. We want to get a lot of work started. We want you walking into every other session thinking about your culture, and how does that session relate to your culture here? How does Michael Phelps and the word that he's talking about relate to your culture? How do we craft a vision and values-based culture? Right, so three stats to help us get started on the right foot. So first, from Harvard Business Review, this helps us answer the question, where do we want to go? All right, so here's the stat. Is more than 50% of respondents said that they didn't think their company had a winning strategy. How many of you would agree that's yours too? Almost 50% of the room, okay? Two-thirds said they didn't think their organization had the right culture and capabilities to execute its strategy. How about you? Okay, actually, we're doing a little better in this room here. That's because you keep coming to the SHRM conferences. All right, yeah, woo! Secondly, is what is going to change, right? From the World Economic Forum, in the next 2 years, 42% of the core skills required to perform existing jobs are expected to what? Change. Agree, disagree? Agree, right? And then the third one from PricewaterhouseCoopers is this. So what do we need to build? With knowing all that we know, what do we need to build? Only 18% of CEOs report confidence in their organization's progress in improving upskilling focused learning programs. It's a mouthful, but does that make sense? Sad stats, yes or yes? Yes. Type yes in the chat if that's a sad stat, right? So with culture being at the center of everything that we do and who we're becoming and how we execute day to day and for the long term, which is what this session is about, we have to remind ourselves that culture is not the pens and the posters and the t-shirts and the mugs. It's so much more than that. But how many of you came into this session because your company thinks its culture is just all the stuff that they put in all the fun, cute slogans and the t-shirts and things? Anyone? Put your hand up real high. This is, I'm not really sure about my armpit, and this is, I have an answer. Okay, awesome. So here's the big questions. Do you know what your culture is, how it was formed, who's influencing it, and if it's driving your business forward or holding you back? Take a moment right now in the chat to write a 4, a 3, a 2, or a 1, and think right now in this room, how many of you have the immediate answer to this question? And you can say yes to all 4. Put your hand up real high if you can say, yes, I know the answers to all 4 of these questions immediately. We've got a tiny, like literally 2 handfuls. How many of you know the answer to 3 of these questions immediately? How about 2? How about 1? How about 0? Who's not going to raise their hand no matter what I ask? Gotcha! Right? So this is the sad reality. The sad reality is most people don't know immediately offhand what your culture was, how it was formed, who's influencing it, or if it's actually driving your business forward or holding you back. More importantly, let me ask you this. Do you think your leaders know? And if you went into different departments and talked to different leaders and different managers, different supervisors, do you think they'd have different numbers as well, yes or no? Yes, absolutely.
So there's a little bit of a disconnect, yeah? So we've got to do something differently. We've got to work on this. And here's what culture needs to be. A long, drawn, run-out sentence first, okay? So here's what we at TSG define culture. It's a living, breathing, dynamic identity. Everyone say living.
Living.
Breathing.
Breathing.
Dynamic. It's a dynamic identity that defines your organization's purpose, direction, and values. Again, about this session, right? Vision and values. Empowering your people to take ownership, where they say, this is my company, this is my organization. Not they make great burgers here, but we make great food, right? Empowering your people to take ownership, to make decisions and drive forward what the organization really needs. Would you agree that's a pretty great definition of what culture needs to be, yes or yes?
Yes.
Also run on sentence, yes or yes?
Yes.
All right. So here in this session, I want to continue to remind you of this idea of purpose, direction, and values. Because your culture drives your strategy, and at the same time, your strategy must be reinforced by your what? Culture, easy question. I thought I gave you the answer. All right. So here's the question. Does your organizational culture shape your vision and values? Take a moment right now, really think about that for yourself. Does your organizational culture shape your vision and values? And like I said, Jack and I are gonna be popping up back and forth. We're gonna be masking and unmasking, and that's just gonna be the fun of the session. So everyone say, hey, Jack, welcome back.
This has been a lot of fun because we have our folks that are out there with us that are having some audio issues. So we are really working hard today for all of you. So we appreciate it. So if you can do me a favor, if you can turn back to the camera, just wave to them and say, we've got your back. Thank you. Let me make sure that they're here with us. So when we really look to do this, right, because how many of you is the culture, as Joe said earlier, it's there, but it's just on the wall, right? It's on a lanyard, it's on a binder, but we're not really living it. If you're with me, say yeah. Okay, so what we need to do is we need to shape this so that beyond the who we are and want to be, strategically we can do something with our culture. If you're with me, say yeah. Awesome, so it's called your four cornerstones. So the four cornerstones, so do me a favor, take a deep breath in, take a deep breath out. Think of this as like the operating system like it is on your phone, right? We all have that operating system that we don't see, but it's there to support the phone, if you're with me, right? This is the same thing for our culture, our strategy, and how do we ensure it drives our capability? So number one, it's about understanding and owning culturally our marketplace, how we play, what we do, and the impact and influence we want to have based on the profit, nonprofit, public, private sector organization you're in. Two is what? For your, oh, we can do better than that. For your customers, who we serve, the value we create. Of course, next is our what? Oh, we can do way better than that. I know, this is your caffeine. Our what? Organization. Obviously, that is our departments, our business units, our regions, and who owns and drives that is our what? Our people. Marketplace, customers, organization, and people. This is the foundation of where culture and strategy and our capability makes a real difference. So let's actually walk you through both a quick case study that will thread throughout the rest of the session and then give you actually your first real tool to start to think about this. So Bosch out in Sunnyvale, California, so Silicon Valley, recognized we need a vibrant culture. We have these different business units and corporate research departments, but we're not really aligned to maximize the impact we can have, not just on the future of Bosch, but our community. We want to be able to attract talent and new businesses that can fuel that vision and make sure that globally they see we're not just a necessary site, but we're critical to the future of the organization. So this was a really tall task, and that's exactly the session you're in, is how do we drive that change or progression forward? So those four cornerstones, the first key thing is not about what is our purpose, mission, and vision, or doing the employee feedback. It's none of that. It's what are the critical questions we as an organizational we as in your department, we as in, of course, you, what are the critical questions we have to ask and answer to shape who we are today and who we want to be in the future at the same time? So let me walk through with you the questions that were built with them to set that foundation. So one, But as you hear these, think about how this relates to what you need to be asking and answering with your executive team and leaders as well. How can we best engage in the Silicon Valley ecosystem to unlock the greater purpose and value as a site in how we provide impactful innovations for life? I'll tell you about the pragmatic how this was used in a moment. Customers, how do we create sustainable solutions that empower our customers and stakeholders to achieve a level of return they will only get here in Sunnyvale, California first? Site, how do we build on each other's strengths to identify the next big thing years before everyone else and drive it through local and global collaboration? Last, people. How do we uncover, activate, and sustain the passions that drive each of us in our work and that lead to contributions that make a significant impact and helps our people realize their full potential? These questions were for the site, each department, each person. So these are your corporate research functions at Bosch Sunnyvale, okay? So they focus on the future of what's possible. These are the business units that take that research and drive the commercial growth and value for customers. But they were on two different planes, different business units. How do these questions shape what we see individually in our teams? But what is the shared narrative that actually is bringing us together to do something of greater meaning? So I'm gonna give to you right now, and then I certainly, you'll be getting these slides after and you'll see how. Take a picture when I'm done. I'm about to give you a blueprint as to how do you, yourself with your HR team, with your executive team, however you decide to start to drive change, whether it's immediate, or if it's something long-term, how to do that. You and others would ask these questions of your top stakeholders or any leader, frankly, okay? This is your blueprint. And the key to framing the questions that actually build and activate your culture is not just a generic question. It's long-term, next year, and how does that relate to right now our priorities in the next 90 days? If that makes sense, say yeah. We can't live in the future. We can't just operate in the present. We got to all do it at the same time. Fair? Here are your questions. Think about this. You're asking these of your stakeholders. So start to picture as I go through these how this connects to the leader you want to talk to first. Think about that person. Think about the reason why this matters to get to the heart of where we want to be and obviously what we want to do. What are the biggest problems we need to solve and those critical opportunities we must seize in our industries, in our communities to realize our greater purpose and potential? And you're asking this of your executives and stakeholders. What must we transform in order to align to the future of our marketplace? Long-term, next year, next 90 days. So this is real. Customers, what is really most important, right? Strip everything away for our customers. And what are the most critical known and unknown needs to fully reach that? Again, you see a constant theme here. What must we transform in order to align the value we need to create with the real impact our customers want? Start to think about the kind of input you would start to get if you asked your top stakeholders these questions and started to connect them in a way that they probably don't even know, I assure you. Organizationally, you'd be shocked at how often, and we've seen this across all the global work we do, how so many people answer this differently. What are the three organizational-wide objectives that are most critical to focus on and why? What must we transform to align the culture and strategy we need to be successful? Again, long-term, 2022, next 90 days. Lastly, people. What are the core mindsets? Capacities. So capacities is the ability to learn, grow, expand. How many of us are in an engineering-based organization? Show of hands. Okay, right? We know in engineering, what's critical in the change of business the past 5 to 10 years is not only do we need to provide that quality, that technical expertise and that service, right, and what we build, what we do, but we have to have a commercial mind. Doesn't mean we have to sell, but we have to understand that. If you're with me, say yeah. Right, capacity and capabilities we need to realize the full transformation we want for our people, to lead our organization, our customers, and our marketplace forward. How many of you feel if your executive team was with you right now and they actually started answering these questions, this would make the first step in the difference you want? How many of you see that? How many of you think they would have a tough time answering these questions? These would be hard questions, right? That's the game to play. So if you haven't done so now, we are going to get you these slides and actually a lot more value in a moment. Take a picture now if you would like, in case you haven't done it. So a lot of cameras, just making sure. So we're going to move on. Let's get to your first step today. Which of the four cornerstones does your organization need to stabilize and strengthen? And just off the top of your head, this is your first step. What question do you need to ask first? Please give yourself permission right now to take a step back and think about this over the next 40 seconds. Which of them is critical? What's the question you'll ask? Please do that now. Mask mics, a lot of fun, a lot of transition. All right, how many of you, was this some good thinking time? Like just to really take a moment to think. Who enjoyed that? Who did not like using your brain? You're like, nope, I want my brain to be off, sorry. I just wanna be a sponge, I don't wanna actually wring it out. You like that, right? Okay. So can we actually just think about for a moment, how many of you chose marketplace? Anybody think about marketplace? Like we better really identify kind of how we wanna show up to our evolving marketplace or community. Okay, couple. How about customers? Hey, we're doing great work, but if we don't change or think differently, we're gonna miss the changes that are coming due to what's going on in our industry, our world, okay? How about organizationally, how we show up, how we come together, how we interact in kind of a better value chain and flow that ensures we're not just a bunch of departments and silos? How many of you have a lot of silos? Say, oh yeah. How many of you, a lot of people that think that it's their world and everything should revolve around them? You didn't think you'd get some red couch time here, did you? Red couch learning objective. You really probably would love that, okay? How many of you, is it about people? Like, we've got to really think about this, right? So what I want to kind of share with you before we move on to our next step of how do we use this space, and again, we're going to be sending you follow-up so you can start to think and work on this when you're done. Beyond that kind of bigger strategic pillars and vision, the first key thing to realize with this is this. How many of you have ever broken a knee, ankle? You've had a physical problem, shoulder, whatever, right? Is the pain that you feel always the root of the problem? No, human anatomy 101, right? Physiology 101, no, right? Same thing with this. We may often think we gotta better engage our people, but what we're not doing yet is really creating an understanding of how do they connect to our marketplace or customer? If we have any banks or credit unions in here, right? A teller sees the moment and the opportunity of the transaction and the relationship, but do they realize the impact they have on that community in terms of how we're trying to revitalize, reinvest, and grow? Without that interaction, we don't create the consistent engagement. We need to engage people, but often it's bigger than that. If you're with me, say yeah. Excellent. So now we're gonna start to take this construct and this framework, which is so critical, and start to look at how we actually shape the strategic pillars and fly vision. So say, Joe, take us forward.
Everyone say, thanks, Jack. Look at these seamless transitions. Isn't it amazing? And now Jack's going to be moderating. I'll be facilitating. Yeah, it's a great day, and we're perfectly on time. Actually, a minute ahead of schedule. We're doing great, Jack. For all this and all the tech glitches that everyone's dealing with back, thank you for your patience. We really appreciate you working with us. There are so many things that everyone else is dealing with. So hybrid events, if you have to do them, avoid them. Avoid them. All right, my mic's on. We're good, right? You can hear me? If you can hear me, say, oh yeah.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so now, do you think asking these questions in the four cornerstones and looking at the fuller scope of your business or your department or your practice, whatever it is that you're trying to do and accomplish, do you think that will help you set up a greater, clearer vision? Yes or yes? All right, great. So we start with the four cornerstones, and now we move into these strategic pillars and your fly vision. And we start this with a pop quiz, because it's a school day. Solve this maze, 10 seconds, go. I'm not kidding, go.
Time's up. All right, who realized immediately, wait, I can't do this, there's no end? Okay, who's still in the maze? If you don't know that there is no exit, if you don't know that there's no way out of this maze, does it matter which turns you make? No. If you don't know what the vision is for your life, for your relationships, for your children, for your significant other, for what you want to accomplish while you're here at SHRM, or what your department or what your organization is trying to accomplish, if you don't know the exit, where you're going, does it matter which lefts or rights or decisions you make? No or no? No. That's the power of the vision. Forget setting goals. Goal setting workshops are great. We've got to focus on where are we going, because the goal is, I got to get through this maze. But why? Where are we going once we get through this maze? All right? So to demonstrate this further, for all of you at home and at work and in your cars, don't do this if you're in your car, and for everyone here, we're going to do a little exercise called the finger point. You're like, oh my gosh, we're going to stand up twice in this session? Yes! Go ahead, put your stuff down. Please stand. You're going to love this one, and you're going to bring this back, and you're going to teach this and share this to everyone that you know, and it will magically, dramatically change their life. If you're ready for that, say yeah. All right, so in the next 3 to 4 minutes, we're gonna transform how you look at vision completely, but you gotta play by the rules. So are you ready to follow the leader? That was a questionable, I don't know what he's gonna ask me to do yet. All right, put your feet about shoulder width apart, easy instruction. All right, do one hula, make sure your hips are stretched, go one way, and then go the other way. Go ahead, great. And now grab your ears like this and go whoop, whoop, whoop. Sorry, that was just for us. All right, in a moment, I'm going to ask you to raise your right arm, and would you like to do this the fun way or the serious way? The fun way, absolutely. And your name is? Naomi? Naomi said fun way, so she speaks for all of us, okay? So here's the fun way. We'll use some sound effects. For all of you at home, I'll hear you as well. So you're gonna raise your right arm in a moment, and it looks like this. And simply point, and that's it, right? And then with your feet locked into the ground, but your hips flexible, you're gonna turn to the right as far as you can. And if you're near somebody's face, just please go over their face, okay? So turn to the right as far as you can, lock in your vision to what you're looking at. I'll ask you to call it out loud so you could identify it. Come back and clap. Is that easy? Yes or yes?
And by the way, if it's a person's body part, you can just say person. Okay? I think we know the nature, but
you can be vague.
We're assuring.
All right, so on the count of three, raise your right arm with those sound effects. One, two, three. So you're pointing directly in front of you. On the count of three, turn to the right as far as you can without moving your feet. I didn't count yet. What's your name? I'm just kidding. On the count of three, turn to the right as far as you can. One, two, three, go. All right, take a look. Call it out loud.
Drapes.
Come back and clap. Put your hands down. And trust me, close your eyes. Ooh. That's right. And if your eyes are closed, I can see that they're open. No tricks. All right? Now, in your mind, all I want you to simply do is imagine that you just raised your right arm and you see yourself visually in your mind. You see yourself raising your right arm. You imagine yourself turning to the point you just got to. You see that point in your mind. Call it out loud again. See it again. Okay? Now, in your mind, what's possible? Anything. Absolutely. Anything and everything. So I want you to see yourself go further just because you can. So in your mind, imagine that you stretched 1 inch further than you did a moment ago. In your mind, imagine that you stretched 2 inches further. Now go 3 inches further. Think about how it feels as you're stretching and feeling more flexible as you go 6 inches, 9 inches, 12, a whole foot further. And when you get to a new point in your mind, I want you to softly say, yeah, now. Okay, good. All right, open your eyes. Now, with sound effects, raise your right arm just like we did before. One, two, three. Zhoo, boing. Now, I want you to see how much further you go because you put a what in your mind? A vision.
Vision.
On the count of three, turn to the right past your first point to get to that new point. Ready, set, go. One, two, three.
Whoa,
And now just because you can, go 2 inches further. Just a little bit more, a little bit more. Oh, that's amazing. And now just because you can, one more inch. No, don't come back, one more inch. Come on now. All right, clap. How many of you went further the second time? How many of you went further when I said, go 2 more inches? Why did you do that? I said, go as far as you can the first time. But you went further the second time and then the third time. Why? You've built a technique. Whoa, you've built a technique, right? You thought about it. You started planning this. You focused on your, use the magic word, vision. Right? Forget the goals if we're going to take these little steps and do these. No. When you have a fascinating, exciting, interesting vision, more things are possible. And when that vision comes directly rooted in the four cornerstones, when you really know what's important and the questions that are important to us, our organization, our team, our department, then it inspires you to craft a better vision. And that vision then re-inspires and reignites the culture. Would you agree? Okay. Now, let me ask you a question. Honestly, how many of you think you could have gone that far the first time, but you didn't because you have some excuses? What are some of those reasons? Laziness, maybe? Who's like, I feel like this is as far as I'm going? I saw your faces. I'm watching, right? Jack was here. We saw it. How many of you thought, maybe I didn't stretch enough, that hurt a little bit? I'm gonna do it. One time, this is a rated PG-13 session. Shit hurts sometimes! But if you let that stop you, every time you got hurt, every time there was a problem, every time there's a conflict in your organization, then what happens? You never get to the vision, never. You're going to have conflict, it's going to happen. All right, now, like I said, this can dramatically change the way you approach people in your organization. So I got to teach you one more trick before you sit down and relax. You're like, how long are we going to stand here, Joe? You're starting to cross your arms looking at me. I see this, okay? If you want to help people see where they let themselves down, where they get there in their own way, this is kind of a fun activity. Do this with your kids, with your family. Bring this back. Do this with your colleagues. If you have someone that is interrupting the most important work you are trying to do in the day, say, hey, I gotta show you something. It's called the finger point. When they close their eyes, just walk away. Go back to work. All right, give somebody a high five or an air high five and go ahead and grab a seat. All right, now the big kicker is this. You'll see it up on the screen as well. Your vision should inspire you to what? Do something, not say something. See, most of us, we talk about the visions, we talk about where we want to go, but that vision should be so exciting, so interesting, that it should inspire us to do something. Right, here's the whole idea. Goals can be smart, right? How many of you have heard of smart goals? Nothing wrong with it. There's 1,000 different ways that we can do SMART goals. They're specific, they're measurable, they're achievable, they're relevant, they're timelined, and I don't know if you knew there's a silent B at the end of SMART goals. It's for boring. Are SMART goals not boring? Yes, they are. They are boring. And we tend to not achieve them unless they're tied to a bigger vision. That's why we want to craft a vision and values-based culture, so that when you have an exciting vision for where you want to go with the maze in your department, your organization, then the goals become easy. Let's just do this, right? So goals can be smart, but your vision must be fly. Everyone say fly, right? F stands for fascinating. Say fascinating. No, say it like you're fascinated when you say the word fascinating. Some of you are like, my voice just cracked. Lucid, everyone say lucid. Right? It's clear. You can see it. When you talk about it, you can see it. Imagine Martin Luther King Jr. on the steps sharing his dream. A dream is just a little bit more of a vague vision. We got more clear as time went on with it. But you heard it. You could picture yourself in that story. It's lucid. It was fascinating. It was lucid. And it's why, say, yearned for. We have been waiting for this. When your vision for your team, your department, the relationships you're building, the relationships with your stakeholders, when it's fascinating, when it's clear, when it's lucid, when it's something that you've been yearning for, and then they start yearning for it as well, then we take action on our goals. Would you agree, yes or yes? All right, so now back to Bosch. Bosch put their vision together, and their vision was 1 + 1 = what? 11. How is that possible?
So you're looking at this, you're like, that doesn't look like
it. I want you to something that actually should be moving something forward, not just stating something academically. So we're going to have a real moment. Say, Jack, let's get real. How many of you have visions, or just the identity, mission, vision, all that stuff, that sits beautiful on the wall, but no one really fully understands it or owns it as theirs? How many of you just don't want to admit it because you're not going to raise your hand? This is what we call the subliminal question, right? So in the work we did there, beyond those cornerstones, shaping the priorities for those business units even further, integrating it, seeing what do we actually want to do, the vision of 1 + 1 means how we show up to our marketplace and community. So when we come together, we're creating an 11, not a 2, a multiplier, for those of you familiar with that book, right? Beyond even that book, it's that larger impact. When it comes to our business units with our teams, how many of you have the issues between teams, marketing to sales, R&D and engineering, engineering to maybe everybody, because engineers are like, you just don't understand what we're doing, right? You just got validated, another red couch, right? Good. If you're with me, say yes, right? Department to department, region to region, people to people. Our vision is about how we show up, which is 1 + 1 = 11, because do what can only be done here in Silicon Valley, Sunnyvale, California, best. That is owned at every level, brand new associate all the way to head of the site, and how we think about not just my role, my purpose, but the organization. So this was something that transformed not just the site, but North American Bosch. So as you watch this clip about the impact this is and continues to have, think about for you, what do we want to grow into? What do we want our vision and strategic focus to be, so that beyond just numbers, goals, and metrics, it's really impact. Enjoy.
To solve life's biggest challenges.
Our people are very special here because they bring passion to the work. They drive innovations forward.
To do what can only be done here. Our culture makes life better.
Our associates make life better.
Our work makes life better.
Silicon Valley is all about talented and motivated people. It's about ideas, and it is about taking these moonshot ideas and making them happen. We have 200 plus really talented people trying to achieve the goals of the teams. Can we achieve something more than the sum of each of these teams? This is 1 + 1 = 11.
We are more valuable side by side.
Before we get to actually how do we take what we've just set up from the four cornerstones to this foundation and craft our vision, how many of you want that as it relates to you? Where the vision isn't just something people say, well, that's about them, that's the executive team, but it relates to on a day-to-day, good days, bad days, and I don't know what just happened day, actually drives how I think and make decisions. Because vision isn't about the future, it's about how I live today. If you're with me, say yeah. So let's now take a look, and Joe's gonna walk us through how do we actually think about crafting a vision beyond all steps that we all know are important, the foundation that we need. Say, hey, Joe.
I'm back. And you're still here. All right, so think about this. Put your hands up like this. Put a one on one side, put a one on the other side. When you put them together, what number do you see? Bless you, and not Roman numeral two, just 11, right? That's the power of it. We create an exponential impact when we all work together towards that vision. So we want to paint a picture. It's fascinating, it's lucid, it's yearned for. We want to tell a story with that vision. Again, that's connected to the four cornerstones. This is how we build that culture. And lastly, we build confidence with all that because people can now see it and they want to move towards that future, right? And we like to say that that future, that vision should be about 4 years. Right? Well, high school's 4 years, colleges, supposed to be 4 years. We elect a president every 4 years, the Olympics, except for right now, are every 4 years. The World Cup is every 4 years. So let's use four as our magical number. So that vision, I know people just randomly choose five because 5, 10, it doesn't matter. It's got to be at least 4 years, but let's four seasons, right? Let's roll and let's flow with it. So the vision, the purpose in the vision, where we go, let's plan that out for the next 4 years, and then let's map it backwards with our everyday focus and those values, those things that we decide are really important to our organization, the behaviors and the way we move towards that purpose and that vision. And this is what we call your strategic path. And the strategic path, I promise I will not go through all of this. You've seen all these words in some way, shape, or form. But your strategic path, we start with that 4-year long term, right? There's the purpose, there's the vision and values, and there's focus areas. We use the focus areas at TSG as our four cornerstones. That's what helps us focus each of those areas. That's the long term picture. Then you wanna match that with the short term picture, right? Between 1 and 4 years, you have your goals. You have your objectives, your OKRs. If you're with me on this so far, say uh-huh. All right. Then you have what's happening actually every single day. You've got your plans, right? We have a daily plan, maybe we have a weekly plan, a monthly plan, but the daily plan has to move us towards the weekly, towards the monthly, right? We have our KPIs, all the key performance indicators that we want to manage and monitor and measure, all the M's, all right? And then we have our rituals. These are the things that we're doing. It's like, Jack did tell you we'll send you the slides, right? You're gonna take 1,000 pictures today. You're gonna take 1,000 screenshots, and what are you gonna do with them? Tell me, what are you gonna do with them? They're gonna sit on your phone. Just like that bag, the SHRM bag, you're gonna bring it back and put it on top of last year's SHRM bag, right? We will send you the slides, I promise. The questions keep coming up in the chat as well, like how do we get a copy of the presentation? Complete an evaluation in about 20 minutes. 12 minutes, I don't know what time it is, doesn't matter, we'll end on time. And we will send you the slide summary, we'll send you some video, some audio, because we only have an hour today, and this is like an 18-hour session, all right? So we're just getting you started here. So within that whole strategic path, you know, the long-term vision boils down all the way to the everyday. So here's your next question, this is your second step. What must change in your culture to balance the everyday focus, the things that you do, your people do, your team does, every single day, with your short-term and your long-term strategic path? I know as we're sharing all this, one thing is coming to mind right now. You're going, that is the thing we need to fix. What is that thing? Take a moment, think about it, or turn to a neighbor and share with them in the next minute or so. Just tell them real quick, this is the thing that's gotta change in our culture so that we can make sure that the things we do every day move us towards the bigger picture that we keep talking about instead of getting stuck in the weeds. Ready, set, go. Think about it or turn to a neighbor, share that now. We'll be right back. All right, give another high five, air high five, fist pound, elbow, or wave. All right, awesome. How many of you immediately, and put a yes in the chat if this counts for you too, how many of you immediately knew the one thing that needed to change that would kind of make all the difference? Put your hand up real high, say, I got it. How many of you have access to making that change happen? Meaning it can come from you or someone that you work with and you got a really good relationship and they're gonna work with you. All right, just by a show of hands, give me one example, two examples, yes. You have a lot of silos. So do you feel like you have the power to reorganize some of those silos? And that can change, which makes it easier to focus on your everyday instead of who do I need to communicate about this? Am I allowed to talk to these people, right? Which chain of command do I need to go through? Whether you like Elon Musk or not, there's a really cool quote that's attributed to him. He put this out there and I don't remember all of the quotes. I'm just kind of being responsive right now. And it's the idea that we have to eliminate the chain of command in communication, not just in general, but in communication, we have to make it less complicated to talk to the person that's going to help us get the job done. I think that's incredible leadership. High five. High fives. Yes. Right? So I'm with you, sister. I love it. I love it. I appreciate that. Let's get one more example. Say that again. You said reactivity? Like it.
I don't even realize if you know this or not, but that was a really good transition to our next section. Couldn't even plan that any better. Because do we not need the strategic, what was your name, by the way?
Shanisha.
Yeah. That's a beautiful name. I could hear it through the mask. I'm glad I didn't disrespect you because it was a great name. So do we not have the challenge of what you said? We're reacting and planning and executing and fixing at the same time. Red couch moment. If you're with me, say, yeah. So how do we do that? As I said when we launched this change with Bosch, because people said, how do we do the everyday and the long term at the same time? We actually have to think about collapsing those two realities so that they become one versus trying to push each other. So how do we do that? There are five core standards. We have been relentless in how do we, which is often missed, evaluate, refine, and then ultimately, to your point, activate not just the strategic focus, but the ability to execute purposefully so we can be agile at the same time, right? Let's look at that. Number one, we have to be what? Relevant. Number two, we have to make sure are people gonna get excited or just say, thanks for the meeting, I gotta go back to do my day-to-day now, that was a waste of my time. If you're with me, say yeah. Three is it's gotta be what? Ongoing. Four, it's gotta be able to be what? When we do M&A and we do expand, we're gonna have to replicate this because we went from 300 to 3,000, which feels like overnight. How many of you have M&A in your life? How many of you wish you didn't sometimes? That was another red couch moment for you. Number five, we have to make sure it's what? Scalable. Is it important? Are people gonna get excited? Are we gonna use and adopt this? Can we carry it forward? And can we ultimately ensure we drive scale in how our culture can align to our strategy so that we're driving our capability internally between our silos, because we are one company if we do it right, and for our customers and what they need now and what they need in the future. Make sense? So again, you can take another picture that you won't use, but you wanna do it now, which is fine because we're gonna get you this stuff as we promised. You can see we like having fun. Relevant is about asking, is the right work at the right time being done with the right people? As generic as that may sound, imagine asking that in your scrums and huddles when it comes to that day and that week. This gets real. Engineering-based organizations, 100%. Let's take a look at the matrix, not just the process within. Two, will people actually be a part of this? Are they gonna see themselves in it or once again say that's good for them? Three, will people adopt this for the long run? These are things you wanna not just evaluate, but actually get people engaged in looking at the ability to execute with purpose and precision with your culture. Reproducing similar results in performance. Do we see a strategic byproduct from what we're doing today to who we can be in the future? That's where you get people really taking ownership, not just being engaged. And lastly, leveraging results throughout the organization, can this scale, create flow, not just more silos over and over and over? These can be used in a 5-minute scrum all the way to a strategic retreat to understand where we are, where we want to be, and is this actually going to hit the ground running? If you're with me, say yeah. All right, your last action before we wrap up, you're going to have just, again, about 30, 40 seconds. Right now, don't overthink it. How will you use these standards to ensure impact from your vision and values as we start to make this real every day and how that drives our long term? Please do that now. Don't overthink it. Could be over the next week, month. How are you going to get started? First step is always the biggest step.
All right, if you're with us, say oh yeah. So you've had three action steps so far, one focusing on your four cornerstones, one focusing on the strategic path of your vision and values, and now here, focusing on these standards that you can use to evaluate the four cornerstones, to evaluate your vision, your values, your culture. Is it relevant, compelling, right? You can use these, so start asking these questions. If this is good stuff so far, say yeah. If you wish this was like an 18-hour session, say, yeah, I could do that. Yeah. All right, so. Off. Okay, crafting a strategic vision and values-based culture. Let's start bringing this home, because now more than ever, the theme of the conference here, right? Now more than ever, what do we need to be doing is use culture as your lens. If you put on red glasses, how do you see the world? Red. If you put on green glasses, how do you see the world? If you put on broken glasses, how do you see the world? The way it is right now. No, I'm kidding. All right, just a joke, right? You're just gonna see cracks, okay? But we want you to use culture as your lens. Use culture as the lens through which you see your vision, and use vision to help craft the culture. All of this works, the strategy, the culture, and your capability to move things forward, all works hand in hand. Just like all of the kind of three big concepts of this session from your four cornerstones, that's shaping your path, right? Helping you figure out where the maze goes, helping you define your future with that strategic path 4 years from now and bringing it back to every day, plus now ensuring your success with these five core standards. So take 30 seconds. How many seconds? 30 seconds, and think about the last 54 minutes of this session. What was your biggest highlight or insight? Say 20 or 30 seconds just for yourself. Make a note of it. Take a look through your notes right now. Go. You two at home. And we promise if you leave this session early, you will miss the end. Just a reminder. Like, I'm going to Michael Phelps. He can swim faster than you, Joe. All right, review those notes, get through all that. And remember, we had a promise that we're gonna have a little bit of fun. Did you laugh? Did you learn? Did you have some fun? Good stuff? All right, now for real though, don't you wish we had more time? Don't you wish you had your executives and the rest of your department and other people here to have this conversation with you? All right, imagine the great work that we could be doing if we were all having that conversation. So as we had promised, take out your phones or open up a new tab in your browser. Here is where the evaluation is. It takes 2 minutes to do, and we will follow up with you with video, with audio. We will literally do this today. So fill this out right here, right now, hit submit, and we will send you follow-up audio, follow-up video. We will make sure that other questions that we didn't have a chance to answer during the chat and during this very short session, we're gonna answer those for the whole community. So take a minute or two as we literally wrap up this session here. Complete the evaluation. It is tinyurl.com/TSG results. Jack will be typing that in the chat as well for you. tinyurl.com/TSG results as we wrap up this session here. And then we'll get you the slides, the follow-up summaries. Make sure you get everything you need to go before you go to Michael Phelps. tinyurl.com/TSG results. You'll see it up on the screen as well, highlighted, if you want the visual too.
No, don't worry.
No worries. That's why we're here. So tinyurl.com/TSG results. Take a moment to do that as we wrap up this session here. And I'll just share with you a couple final thoughts and words as you do that. First, your participation in person and on chat, your energy level through the roof. I love it. We are the warm-up act for Michael Phelps. This is fantastic. We love that you are here. If you have any questions or thoughts, we will stick around for sure at the end of the session. You can come check in with us if you've got any specific questions, if there's anything else that you want to know about some of the work that we might be able to do with you to support you. But again, tinyurl.com/TSG results. We'll make sure to send you all the things that you need and anything afterwards as well. If you need to schedule an appointment with us, you can certainly do that while we're here as well. Otherwise, thank you so much for your energy, for your participation. Over there and in here, if you had a great time, say, oh yeah. Thanks for coming. My name is Joe. This is Jack. We'll see you around soon.